Welcome to youtube.com/evilsqueegyrar and or twitch.tv/evilsqueegy. That's still weird saying that the other way around. I'm Evil Squeegee. Today I will be your game master. It's a game master. I am your laser master for lasers and feelings. Today.
No, they call it a GM.
Do they GM? Yeah. Okay. Today, you shall witness a daring adventure of daring do and dairy. Of dairy do.
Does this make this a dippity-doo?
Yes.
Okay.
Today's adventure is most certainly not sponsored by Dippin' Dots. I don't want there to be any confusion.
I don't know what that is.
But before we get started, I would like to make...
The ice cream of the future.
I would like to make a few explanations here. One, if you see a player doing something that you truly like, or something that is truly funny happens, or something that is astounding, if you are staring at your screen like, oh, I need you to shout beat at the top of your tiny typey lungs. Tiny typey lungs.
I was like, your tiny typey lungs. Wait, no, he said type. Yeah, typey. It's fine.
Your tiny typey lungs shout beat in all caps. I will do something nice for the players when that occurs. But it requires that five of you shout beat. Players are not allowed to shout beat.
Five is the number that shall shout.
Thou shalt shout to. Type two. Yes.
Why are we not laugh tracking today?
Do you want to laugh track?
Oh god, that could be horrific.
Oh, a laugh track.
That it's a bit of a pain to get set up, but
no, we can do this. We can do a laugh track. Right then, now. I don't know why.
I got no idea why
I'm suddenly Australian. All right,
just went from Aussie to fucking Nick.
All right, okay. Calm.
I'm already losing laughter.
Calm down, Lassie.
Eyes for fuck's sake.
Yeah, that's right. I went there, Zhang.
Okay.
You were the one who pushed out on my idea today. You don't get to talk shit.
I mean, I liked it.
Right then, don't get your knickers in a twist.
All right, so the rules of Laugh Track are as follows. One, if you make someone laugh, that someone loses a point. Everybody starts with 10 points, all right? If there is ever a question as to whether or not something counts as a laugh, the chat will decide. All right? Everybody starts at 10.
I hate this shit.
Pyromancy, you are officially, as the men who shouted, Laugh Track! In all capitals, you will be the men tracking everybody's score.
Good.
All right. Zhang is like, woohoo!
I was literally like, oh, okay.
Now, also moving forward, it is imperative that you understand what is meant when I say unnatural dice. Unnatural dice is our method of thanking you, the viewers, who decide to fiscally support the show by donating. Upon donations of... was it $1 or more? There are a wide variety of options available to you, the viewer, from our unnatural dice shop to inflict upon the players. You may choose specific players and give them bonus dice or less dice. You can give them crits or botches. You can inflict twists of fate upon them. And you won't even know what that is until it happens. All of the information can be found on our webpage, which is accessible by typing hype mark support. We thank you for your support. It enables the show to continue. And I truly hope that Zhang Mac does nothing but botch all damn day.
Wow.
Because he shot down my idea.
It's worth noting that as the GM, you don't actually roll in this.
Yes, do not buy dice for me.
Yeah. Also, I'm just assuming that if we're going for like an advantage or disadvantage, we can just add a die or take a die away.
That's exactly what resistance and so on will do. So, I've got Pyromancy on the dice, I've got Pyromancy on the laugh track. Today's adventure will begin, but only after we create our characters. Lasers and Feelings is a game where everybody creates their characters by selecting from a list. Now, who wants to go first?
I have Chris down to go first.
Whatever.
Kajah! You must choose a style for your character. Your options consist of the following.
Are we actually not doing the original plan?
No. Zhang Mac pushed out, so I can't.
Damn it.
Choose a style for your character. Alien, android, dangerous, hotshot, intrepid, savvy, or sexy?
Hmm. This is a very important question to me, fundamentally speaking.
Too sexy or not too sexy? That is Kajir's question.
That's always the question in this game.
No, I actually, I tend to enjoy Hotshot in general, but it's really hit and miss. I'll go with Alien.
Damn it!
I don't know if you can be weird enough, Chris.
Really?
Yeah. All right, down the list. Zangmak, before you lies a list that does not have the word alien on it that is otherwise perfectly similar to the one that you just heard me list off to Kajir.
Sarah's next on the list.
Oh, Sarah, before you lies a list of options that is very similar to the one that I just presented Kajir with but does not include the word alien. What do you do?
I'm going to be dangerous.
Dangerous.
Wow, that danger face. Holy shit, do that again.
Dangerous.
See, look at that. That's fierce.
Highway to the danger zone.
That's Screechy's danger face is something completely different. See, Sarah's danger face is like fierce. Screechy's danger face is like keep your children away. That's Grant, these I need two.
Every time you talk, I need to stop listening.
Laugh track starts with the gameplay.
Oh, come on.
Oh, good. I can laugh till then. Perfect. I'm going to get all of my system.
Grant,
good.
I need your...
No, you're not. You are awful at laugh track.
I know. That's why
I need your arms to get T-Rexin.
Get T-Rexin.
It's like traditional thrillering, except a bit shitter.
So hold on. If there's thriller involved... Does this mean the Jackson 5 will be making an appearance today?
No.
Maybe.
Maybe.
Only because Zangmak said no, though.
Fine. Fine. I'm going to be sexy.
Oh, Jesus.
Oh, God. I know who you're going to play. You don't even know who you're going to play yet, but I do. I'll give you a hint, Zang. It's going to start with dinosaurs. Zang is like, ooh.
Okay. Is this an Ark reference?
No.
Not yet.
No. That also means saying that you...
Shit, I can't remember his name.
It was Scientist is also taken.
You want me to play that?
Yes. Okay, I can play that guy. That's what we're doing.
What was his name?
He was the sexy scientist, and I forget what his number was.
He was all feelings, I'm pretty sure.
He was a pretty shit scientist.
Yeah, he was like the worst scientist.
Alright, with Zangmak settled, Kajir.
I guess I should make note of this. Actually.
You are an alien what? You could be a doctor, an envoy, an engineer, an explorer, a pilot, or a soldier. What do you do?
I think I will make an attempt at the alien doctor.
I swear to God, if you play Zoidberg, I am going to kick you in the teeth. Sarah?
Well, my alliteration has been destroyed, and I cannot be the dangerous doctor. Therefore, I shall be the dangerous
dickbag?
Is that a code? I subscribe to prescribing cyanide.
I subscribe to prescribing?
Yes.
I'm going to be the dangerous pilot.
Oh, God.
Matthias, is that you?
Now, each of you shall choose a number from 2 to 5. A high number means you are better at lasers, such as technology, science, cold, rationality, calm, and precise action. A low number means you are better at feelings, such as intuition, diplomacy, seduction, and wild, passionate action.
Yeah, which meant my number was actually 2, not 5.
Yes.
Yep.
What?
A woman driver. Good job, Pyre. I appreciate that.
I mean, I was already dangerous, so.
What numbers are you going with?
I'll go with 4.
A low number means you're better at feelings.
Yeah.
My number's going to be 2.
Yes. I'm there with you, Sarah. 2 all the way.
2, yep.
Kajir.
Shall be the most passionate landing of spaceships you've ever seen in your life.
You know what? Just to go with this, I'm gonna go for 5. Just to stick with
the alien who simply does not understand people.
Mm-hmm.
I find that most of most problems can be solved with duct tape and glue.
And if they can, you just need more duct tape. Right?
Right. Step number four. Each of you must choose a cool space adventure name, like Sparks McGee or something.
I'm struggling to remember what the guy's name was.
Was it not Vale Flu Flamu?
No, that was not Vale Flu Flamu.
He was the alien scientist.
The screechy noise in the King Tina.
Yay, space!
That was Vale Flu Flamu. Fuck, what was his name? It was like Hank or something like really bizarre that I wouldn't usually pick. Can anyone in chat remember?
I don't even remember, dude.
What about you?
Impregnate your women and perform science. That guy.
I can't remember.
I never saw this character.
The best part about watching Zangai play this character is that he has to play two heads who can only agree on how sexy they are, and that is the only thing they are allowed to agree on.
Oh, God, I forgot about that. I fucking forgot about that shit.
Kajak.
I was not here for this character.
You are an alien doctor. What is your cool space adventure name?
Do, 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 do.
I almost want to say it's Zubarg.
Zubarg. Sarah.
Ginger Wild. Dangerous pilot.
Ginger Wild.
Ginger Wild? Fucking brilliant.
Am I allowed to take offense?
Is that with an E on the end?
Yes. Yeah, that's okay. Yep.
Ginger Wild with an E. And Zangmag.
Not Ginger Wildy.
Whose name shall henceforth be referenced as,
that one guy!
That one guy. Well, those two guys.
Those two guys.
Only
one, really.
Right. It was a transporter malfunction resulted in him having a second head when he was saving Mystic. But they disagreed with each other on everything. Fuck.
At least we're not requiring you to play four people.
We must now create the ship. You must pick two strengths from the following list. Your ship may be fast, nimble, well-armed, have powerful shields, superior senses, a cloaking device, or be fighter craft.
Did he just say powerful shears? We're an intergalactic shearing ship.
Shields. I believe fighter craft is actually supposed to be like where you get on like the one-man pods to like go fly and blow things up.
Ooh, I want that.
I'll go with whatever you guys want, but I think we have to have the...
Zang is too busy shooting down my ideas to agree to anything you guys are proposing.
I'm not shooting down any
Bless you!
Bless you.
Bless you!
Oh.
Powerful sneezes.
Yes.
I think that goes with superior sensors.
So it was in America. I found the video.
So, Ginger Wild.
Radley Spacebuck!
Radley Spacebuck, yes! Alright, so, Ginger Spacewild has decided that fighter craft are one of the strengths of the ship. Kajer, you have one to choose because Zangmak has opted out because he only shoots down good ideas.
Well, that's why we have the fighter craft.
Yes.
I believe it should be superior sensors.
Superior senses. All right. Collectively, the group must settle on a single problem. It is either a fuel hog, which means it
horrible
always needs
breakers.
More.
Horrible circuit breakers.
Horrible circuit breakers.
I was going to say only one medical bay.
Nah. You don't know, Chris. You don't know.
Nah.
Horrible circuit breakers are all the way. What was the other one? I've got superior senses and what? It's a
fighter craft,
okay.
All right. Now... As we move forward, you'll be rolling dice. How do you roll dice? Well, you start with 1d6 if you have an assist, or you are prepared, or you have, you can argue that this falls within your expertise, and I approve of your argument. Note, this is an important part of the process, because otherwise Chris will have an excuse for everything to fall under alien. You will gain one dice for each of the qualifying factors. If you are rolling lasers, such as attempting a task that is science or reason, you must roll underneath your number. If you are rolling for feelings, you must roll over your number. One success means you barely manage it. Two successes means you do it well. Three successes is a critical success. If you roll on your number exactly, you get laser feelings. On your screen for the players, there is a list of questions that you may select from to ask every time you roll a laser feeling. You may then re-roll that die. You can also help somebody else and grant them an extra die. The GM must now create a space adventure. I'm going to do this quickly by rolling on this chart. All right. Five. Cyber zombies. Did I just get quantum tunnel again?
No. Holy shit, there's no
quantum tunnel. What? No quantum tunnel?
Cyber zombies want to steal or capture an ancient space ruin, which will fix everything. Hey, I did say we were starting off where that last adventure left off, did I not?
Yeah.
For those of you who are just tuning in, the last two adventures of Lasers and Feelings that I ran ended crash landing in the prehistoric era. Don't ask me how this keeps happening. I don't know. I just know that it will happen, and or has already happened, or both. Now I'm confused. Our adventure begins!
Which will fix everything.
Which means...
What the fuck is that?
It means Laugh Track is starting.
The Laugh Track begins now. The rules for Laugh Track are as follows, just as a reminder. If you laugh, you lose a point. You have 10 points. The winner, at the end, will get something very special for the next gameplay broadcast they participate in. There is a prize. Do not squander it. In a galaxy not too far away, but a time that is definitely long, long ago and or potentially far into our distant future, depending on which end of the quantum tunnel you are staring into.
We just discussed there's no quantum tunnel.
There existed multiple instances of the Raptor. A powerful ship with fighter craft and strong shields, but a tendency to explode when you least expect it.
What if I always expect it?
At multiple points in time, the Raptor has been sucked into time travel, crash landing at the same point in time. Prehistoric Earth. Randy. The compartment for storage, the hull, has a ramp, and it opens with a and you step down, and as I recall, the last thing you said was,
I'm here to impregnate your women and perform science. Well, we are here to impregnate your women and perform science. Is that I, or is that? We are here. Because he has two heads. I was having a conversation.
You are greeted with the cacophonous applause of nothing. Well, maybe there's a dinosaur screeching in the distance and you can see a stegosaurus. Ah! That's not what dinosaurs sounded like, but it'll have to do for our simulation purposes. Unfortunately, we were not able to acquire live dinosaurs for this broadcast. I'm very sorry.
The budget is a little bit slim. I'm sorry. Yeah.
The best we could do was a duck. We decided to use Chris instead. No. No, you're not going to make me laugh with duck noises, Sarah. You'll have to try harder than that.
Have to try harder than that!
You must be quackers.
You're not going to make me laugh with puns, so...
Oh, yes, I am.
I was talking to Chris, but okay.
Oh. No, he won't. Now!
Tangamak's very serious about this impregnation.
Randy! As you proudly proclamate your pregnant intent to the world of prehistoric predators, perchance you perceive a parcel of interest on the horizon. You have just exited the Raptor, but just over that way, you see the smoldering wreckage of the raptor. What do either of you do?
We should totally make sure that the crew said no. We should go and investigate that crew, because our crew are probably no. There might be new women to appreciate our awesome sexiness. I'm going to investigate the new ship.
But are they as dangerous as me?
Ginger Wild, pilot extraordinaire, steps down next to both of you, Randy, on the ramp, proclaiming her dangerousness as she gazes piercingly across the horizon.
Where the hell did you come from, and who the fuck are you?
I'm Ginger Wild, the dangerous pilot. Who are you? And you?
I'm getting used to this. We are Randy Spacebuck.
Both of you are Randy Spacebuck.
Well, technically it's only one, but there's two heads, but two heads are better than one.
I suppose so, in certain instances. I pilot the raptor, which this appears to be the raptor, but that also appears to be the raptor, which means something fishy's going on.
I like it.
Me too. Shall we investigate?
Will there be science to be performed?
Probably.
We are will gay. There be,
will there As be long... danger to pilot?
I don't know, but I can make it dangerous if you want me to.
Maybe, if you're good.
For the sweet love of God, Kajer, I need you to interrupt these two flirting at each other. It's starting to hurt me.
Nope. I don't actually know where I am.
You are on the ship, being a dangerous... No, an alien doctor.
Doctor. Yes, but am I on this ship or the other ship? Or is there perhaps a third ship?
Very well, we shall discover this. Randy? Ginger? Randy?
Ginger.
No, just,
nope, nope,
just,
nope.
Just one Ginger.
Randy, Ginger, Randy.
Don't correct the narrator, it's bad form.
Oh, wait. Oh, I thought you were just repeating your... Oh.
No. You walk...
It's like a Ginger Randy Oreo cookie.
You walk across the tall, grassed field.
Have you know I strut majestically? I do not walk.
And I stomp.
Does the grass actually
I am going
part?
To need to witness this for it to become reality in 3, 2, 1, strut and stomp, go!
Except it's kind of odd because the two heads are like offsetting and then...
Are you stopping and moving?
Is this, I think, two heads and one body?
Yes.
Okay, good. That's what I thought.
Not originally.
Are they like a tumor and one's growing off of the other head?
It's kind of like separated and so it's like two necks, like coming from slightly wider parts of the shoulders. Yeah.
And as you walk across the field and the music of the jungle begins to play in the background, and you don't seem to recognize it because actors never recognize music in the background when they are acting. I saw that.
It definitely does not sound like I bless the rains down in Africa.
No, it definitely does not.
Damn
it. No, I love in Randy Spacebuck's head, he's like a wimblewit, a wimblewit, a wimblewit, a wimblewit. Wow, the leafling.
I got
it. Yeah.
Here I was going with, welcome to the jungle!
But oh, that's apparently... a good one too. So we all have different jungle space music.
Everyone has their own different jungle space music for dinosaurs.
Which makes sense why everybody's walking so differently. It's because they're actually all walking their
own soundtrack. As you strut and stomp across the horizon, trees are moving this way and that. Well, they're not moving, you're moving past them, but it's one of those terribly animated sequences where the trees are moving and they don't really stay in the same place because the artist can't draw very well.
Are the trees just on wheels and somebody's rotating the wheel?
Maybe off camera. There might be some whole contraption causing like all the pieces to move around the stage. and you approach the wreckage of the raptor. I need both of you to roll me some sort of investigation check. I'm going to call this lasers to assess your surroundings.
Well, shit. I'm gonna flip out my, whatever the fuck it's called, my super sweet space phone camera communicator scanner thing.
Which is on the sheet for the game. It does exist.
It is specifically that. That is what it's called.
To get the bonus, you must read that exact title. Otherwise, I will not know what item you are using.
Mm-hmm. Mm. It also has a universal translator. With variable beam phase pistol set to stun. Mine's set to science. So
what does shooting somebody with science do?
Science? Duh!
Science.
Come on.
Have you never done science?
Would I like one?
Have you never done science?
No.
No, you've never done science. How are you a doctor if you've never done science? Doctors must be so strange in alien worlds.
It's practice.
Let me see those rolls.
I will say
that you have a tool, and in addition to having a tool, you know what you are looking at. It is the raptor, so you have familiar with it. I will allow both of your two dice total.
Okay. I rolled under my number.
Wow. Damn. Yeah, I actually got one. Holy fuck.
I did.
Damn.
I had nothing, so it goes wrong.
My super sweet space phone camera communicator scanner thing is in the form of a pair of glasses, which will be seen in the next second. Anyway.
You will both discover the same thing, but you will discover very different parts of it. The dangerous pilot, Ginger Wild, immediately looks towards the cockpit, where the piloting mechanics might be mechanized. As you open the door, you step in and you see... What the hell was Kajer's name again?
Zubarg,
a strange and alien creature wearing one of those weird things under like the satellite headbands that doctors have for some reason and nobody ever explains what they're for. And then, also, he's got the white lab coat. Does that count as a laugh? I need to know from the audience if I just made Sarah laugh.
What does your alien look like?
I swear to God, if you say dick wolves, I'm going to throw you off this stream instantaneously. I believe I just made Chris laugh.
You did.
Yeah, you did. Mine was more of a
I'll
face
take
ball.
One for
I didn't
the dick
exhale.
Wolves.
Dick wolves. Oh, and Pyro says will, yes, Sarah.
Yeah, but he's keeping track of the sheet, so he doesn't count.
I will take one from the dick wolves.
Well, there you go.
Not making me laugh with that, Chris. Nope.
I can't believe you went for the dick wolves. That's low, man. That's low.
Have you met me?
So basically, one side is kind of orange, but mostly humanoid. It's kind of looks a little bit like Goro on his left side because he's got two arms, and a much more elongated jaw. But the other side is almost completely looks like a jellyfish.
What?
So the other side is like just gelatinous and ends in a bunch of tentacles.
It's just like a really shit transformation, like that's been stopped halfway through.
Yeah, the evolution.
So basically, you're playing Batamus Photoshopicus, the Speciesicus,
with jellyfish tentacles.
No,
Apithecus.
Okay,
a source.
You discover a terrifying creature. Half jellyfish, half man, wearing one of those weird satellite headbands that doctors wear, and a white lab coat, and he is unconscious, as if he had been desperately slamming upon the pilot machine that he did not understand how to use when his ship crashed in Dinosaur Land. Meanwhile, Randy, discover a very different aspect of this creature. As you come around the outside of the ship, you behold through the window the most amazingly arousing ass you have ever seen in your life, pressed against the window of the cockpit.
Good God, that's beautiful! Not as sexy as our own, but
good.
Yep, the Raptor's a nice looking ship.
I'm talking about the ass. That ass.
Kazaa.
Yes.
I have a very strange request. I must know what it is like to see you unconscious in the cockpit of a spaceship with your ass pressed against a window.
There is no feasible way for me to do this without flipping my desk. Although I have considered this very carefully.
Well, you could take your headset off and back up so you're in the shot and show us that way. You can sit on the couch. The couch is in the shot.
Of all the things you have asked Chris to do on camera, I think this is out there. It is out there. And we're not just talking like prehistoric lands. This is far beyond anything.
I believe I just saw Chris laugh.
Mm-hmm. No, this is me reflecting deeply in thought. I'm actually just smiling. I'm trying to figure out.
Sarah's at 9, and now we have to have a poll for Chris.
Okay.
Notice Zang Mac, how we don't sit there and yell profoundly when we didn't really laugh. We just accept what's handed to us via the poll. Wow. Zang Mac.
Why you gotta be a bitch about it?
My name's Zang Mac, and I'm bitch about the rulings, and I don't like it because I shoot down Glenn Helios and I shoot down the game because I'm okay.
How am I supposed to know when to come back?
I love the way that you two came together at the end there. It was like, yeah.
Okay. Oh, wait.
It was beautiful.
I will motion.
No, it's okay, because...
Oh, you're wireless.
Wireless, yes. Yes.
All right.
Because now I will know...
All right, so this is what we happened upon. Hold on. You need to... Can you... Okay, assume the camera is the window. Could you do that for me?
I can't look at this.
That's not enough pressing of the ass.
Better.
Almost got me! Almost. So, Randy, behold, the ass.
My God! I just want to caress and touch it at the same time with 5 hands that I've yet to acquire through strange teleportation accidents.
Could be dangerous. You should totally do it.
I like you.
Did you just rub your ass on camera? Yes, he laughed!
You can't prove it.
Yes, I can.
You can't.
I can. You can come back now. Thank you. I appreciate. You can now say that there is nothing you won't pantomime.
I'm actually going to take a picture of it with my super sweet space phone camera communicator scanner thing with universal translator and inbuilt variable beam phase pistol, which is usually set to stun, except in my case, it's set to science.
Stunning science?
So I'm
Might have set to danger zone.
We're not
which is just way. A playthrough of like... Bah, 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 bah,
bah, bah, bah, the audience has decided that your reflection included an unconscious laugh, Chris.
Interspersed with Archer quotes.
It's a 50-50 vote.
The bot randomly picks it. It's not like it's an unfair tiebreaker.
What an asshole.
And then the laugh that nobody can...
That's prove. What I thought!
What did you think?
What an asshole.
So, there you are, gazing upon the most horrific and or sexy creature you have ever seen, depending on which angle you are viewing it from. What do you do?
I'm horrified and I'm aroused at the same time, and I think I like it, but I'm not sure, but I think I do.
He has got all these controls completely out of whack. No wonder he crashed. Get up!
Surprisingly, the unconscious alien does not respond to your verbal commands.
I'm gonna touch it.
I say it louder. Get up! While he touches it.
I believe I'm still unconscious.
Yes. Shouting does not seem to rouse the alien. Touching it, however... I do believe this is definitely a feelings moment for you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to say that touching a sexy ass is definitely something that falls within your expertise. You have at least two dice.
It was one of my character goals to meet sexy aliens.
So you may roll me two dice, aiming for a five or lower.
Should I also be rolling feelings, given that I am on the receiving end
of the touching?
You
I do it laser well. Feelings?
This is the most well anyone has ever touched your unconscious ass.
I also have laser feelings.
Zargond. Zagrond. Zagorborg.
Zubarg.
Zubarg. Zabalugugudarg.
Velagugun.
Demogorgon.
Oh. Demogorgon.
The audience has decided that you did not, in fact, laugh on the couch. You remain at 8 points. So, can you do me a favor? Zangmak, Kajer, I need you to show me what the nicest ass-touching ever looks like. Because this is going to rouse you, possibly arouse you. And I need to know what this looks like. All right, so this is a dual effort in role-playing only on Twitch.tv. Will you ever see the most amazing of role-plays? This is your chance to break, Sarah.
I slowly approach the half jellyfish, half two-armed body, rubbing my hands. Not in glee, but warming them up so that they are not cold to the
touch. I can't go back to the couch for this because we will, in fact, end up breaking Twitch terms of service if this goes too much further. So, I'm going to stay seated here.
Sarah's preparation alone is actually almost enough to make me chuckle. I'm just
I have
saying.
Never seen somebody take so many deep breaths.
Not to
Sarah's,
laugh
Sarah's over here like, Zangmak's gonna touch Chris's ass. Give me the bro fist. Give me the bro
fist. I don't even know who you're asking to
everybody. The men and the lads, this is a collective effort to crack Sarah. I believe that is. Is that the second time you're down to 8 points?
8 points, yep.
All right, now.
I mean, Sarah's the one trying so hard, but I thought it was me that was getting roused.
So there's your touchdown, boys. I need you to go for the point conversion.
Okay. So I'm walking along, and the music that was in the background, the actors don't usually hear.
Yes.
It's like, boom, ba-na-na-na-na-na. I believe in miracles. Where you from? You sex thing. And then a slow caress of the cheek. And literally, I'd like full on slap.
Like,
yeah.
And then a nice slow caress.
And then a gentle caress.
At what point do I wake up in this? I need to know.
Whichever point you feel is most comedically valuable to you as the actor.
Okay. So, are you actually going to be acting out the slapping for me, then?
Oh, I literally just did that. Right.
Ready?
I need a sound effect.
It needs to be a whole thing. Ready?
Yes.
Three, two, one.
I believe in miracles. Where you from? You said the thing. Ooh.
Hi. What's wrong? You seem distressed. Is there danger about?
I don't jiggle there. What happened?
Jiggle? What do you mean jiggle?
I'm sure I felt some motion in the ocean. Did you, good to see you awake. Are you a woman?
This isn't an ocean.
It's metaphorical. It's science talk. You might not understand.
Science is not metaphorical.
Wait, are you science?
What kind of science? Are you a scientist, woman? No, you wouldn't know if it was science talk or not.
Oh,
that's our job.
The two heads.
She might. Two head. Shut up, head.
Listen to him. He knows what he's talking about.
Wait, is it just a head or is it a person?
What?
It appears to be a man with two heads. Not sure how it happened, but I intend to find out.
Not just any man. Randy Spacebuck.
Oh. Yeah, never heard of him.
You will have by the end of tonight, I can assure you.
I just did, but okay.
Fine.
Where's the ocean?
I don't know, I haven't seen one yet. Right now, we just have a couple instances of the same ship in the same location.
The science said there was an ocean.
And there's more important matters at hand. There's regarding where
the ocean. Yes, something about something. Are you a woman? What?
Are you, in fact, a woman? I can't tell from your jiggly bits to your multi-arm appendages. I'm not a doctor. I'm a scientist, damn it.
He wants to know if you're female.
A what?
I don't believe his species has sexes the same way that we would speak of.
Okay,
sir,
it's very simple.
Randy.
This is a woman. Tits, vagina, arousing. This is a man. Penis, pecs. Twin heads. Very
This is a woman. Tits, vagina, arousing.
I was trying so hard to be offended.
Oh, God! I
can't. Well, that's seven.
Oh, what am I down to, nine or eight? I forget. I think I'm down to
nine.
If you do not understand these simple concepts, then how does your species procreate? And is it fun?
Actually, we each have a... Hold on, let me just kind of... I will pull, like, one of the tentacles will move down, and we'll kind of, like, just pull some of the jelly off, and it will clean it out. And then... one of the two arms will start punching the jelly repeatedly.
Fuck's sake!
Down she goes! That's gonna be six for Sarah.
Yep, that's okay.
Wow, you are going woo!
I know, I'm tanking now. I was doing so well at first.
You often go down like this quickly, Sarah, minutes. I'm just curious.
The activity you just described? No. Absolutely not.
Now that is pounding, and that's something I understand. I'm gonna punch that jelly.
And on that note, it is top of the hour. You can now laugh. Laugh track is paused. Holy shit! Welcome back to youtube.com/evilsqueegyrar and/or twitch.tv/evilsqueegy if you're watching live. If you've stuck around this far, thank you for sitting through the ad break. Those ads help support the channel. We are playing live. We are playing Laugh Track. I realize I didn't get it up on the screen yet, but Laugh Track is, if you laugh, your score goes down by 1 point. The person with the highest score, which will most assuredly not be Sarah by the end of this, will get a special bonus at the start of the next gameplay stream. All right, everybody can laugh one last time before we get going. Ready? Three.
We're all.
Two.
Much.
One. Really? That's it? I'm just the only one laughing? Fuck you, people! Fuck you guys!
I don't want to get it warmed up again, you know? Like, I'm feeling.
Wait, hold on. What are you warming up? Because in the context of this, the last thing that was being warmed up was my ass.
I mean, I wasn't involved in that.
Mm hmm.
So
it's like, wasn't me. All right, so.
Wasn't me.
Laugh track begins in 3, 2, 1. Poker faces, people. When we last left off, the party had just discovered a strange alien in the cockpit of a ship that was identical to their own. This is very strange, considering that that ship had crash-landed in just about the same place as this ship had crash-landed, which is even stranger because we only got here by means of a malfunctioning quantum tunnel and find ourselves in prehistoric Earth. After some deliberation, it is determined that, yes, in fact, this alien has the capacity to be sexy. This pleases Randy. We don't know what Ginger's response to this is, or if she has one.
That's why I'm in the driver's seat, because I want to see if the ship works.
All right, why don't you roll me lasers to identify the working mechanical bits of this monstrous spaceship?
Before I do that, could I describe the way in which I try to determine if the ship is working?
You want to actually roleplay? What do you think this is, a role-playing show? Yes.
All right, so because I am a passionate and dangerous sort of pilot, the way that I test to see if the ship is working is I'm going to like feel along the panel for the little lever, flip up the panel, and then As opposed to, you know, using like visual stimulus, I'm just gonna feel and see if the wires feel right.
Is this visual stimulus? This is what came to mind when you said visual stimulus.
In a sense.
Specifically touch or sight? Which of the senses?
I'm not using sight, I'm using touch instead. Feeling the energies of the ship moving through it. Because flying a ship is a little bit like yoga.
All right.
I'm going to
roll me feelings because yoga.
Hold on, she might end up getting a penalty because given that she's trying to feel wires, I assume that this is some kind of science that I'm not aware of, and so I will take the conductive jelly that is in my hand and I will throw it onto the console that she's currently feeling.
Roll me three dice.
Who?
You!
Me! Excellent. Why isn't it rolling?
They see her rolling. Passing. Three! Critical success! That means I have to come up with a very fancy thing that is nice for you.
Also, I rolled laser feelings.
No,
yep.
A feelings roll, she has to roll under a two. So she got the feelings?
What? No, I have to roll over a two.
Over your number.
Sorry. My bad. I
got laser feelings.
So, you may ask one of the questions provided to you by the fancy sheet that the audience cannot see.
Okay.
what are they really feeling? Who's behind this? How can I get them to blank? What should I be on the lookout for? What's the best way to blank?
How can I get this alien to get out of my seat?
Well, Kajer, what would be the best way to get this alien out of your seat? Hmm? Inquiring minds want to know. Also, the GM is making demands.
The best way to get the alien out of the seat would be to injure somebody else nearby.
As for the rest of your critical success, you are feeling the cables. Can you show me that? Show what it feels like, all right? Now, as you're feeling, you are going to encounter something slightly slimy, but instead of being disgusted, you must know that this is the very intriguing jelly. This is very sexy jelly. This is definitively sexy. Ooh, this jelly feels so nice.
It's sexy.
Yes, it Jexy.
I can honestly say I've never touched a sexier jelly in my life.
I honestly thought you were going to say sex jelly then, and I was like, I'm pretty sure that's on the market already. That's copyrighted.
Just sexy jelly, hashtag not sponsored.
Other jellies are appropriate.
The sexiest of jellies.
Now, you were feeling to see if the ship was operable. It should be. It definitely should be. However, it is not. Why not? Well, as you are feeling that, so jelly. Oh. Ooh. What? Oh,
I'm totes.
Your fingers. Right now. They slip into a hole. This is generally one of the best experiences of your life, but in this instance, holes in sexy jelly are not. There's not supposed to be a hole here, that's the problem. There is a missing piece, and once you are able to pry your mind away from the raw sexiness of the jellied hole. No?
No. Nope. Raw sexiness of the jellied hole? Totally straight face?
So the humanoid head will kind of like sink into the jellyfish side, mm-hmm. and it will pop out on the other side of the jellyfish, and it will be like right in front of Ginger Wild. And it will say, "What are you feeling?"
I feel something very sexy, but not nearly dangerous enough.
But no, the jelly is so that it's not dangerous. It prevents friction.
Well, then get this shit off me.
I mean, it's... I can't.
You heard the lady.
Why not?
It's not water soluble.
What? How do I get it off? How do I get off the jelly?
This is
I'm not sure that... I don't know if it's appropriate. We just met.
Is it soluble in anything?
It's flammable.
How did I know? Is it that Chris really? And Sarah goes down. That was a joint effort. There we go, Chris. You were like fire, and I was like Chris plus fire equals really. And Sarah was like
Wow. Chris has found a way to make his sexual oozes flammable in a game.
That sounds dangerous.
All right, Darkwing. Yes! God. Yes! Yeah! Fuck you, Chris! Yes!
I was expecting the Darkwing! Son of a bitch. I was going to crack a KY joke, but Unimmortal actually got to it just before I was about to say it in character. I was just like, well, now I can't.
Right. The important part here, though, as you look at your sexily jellied hands and consider possibly setting them on fire, which would be very dangerous. The piece of your ship that was missing is integral to the fuel systems. It could be very explosive if put in the wrong hands.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not the sort of thing that would just fall out. This piece of this machine does not just plop. It has to be unfastened. It has to be snatched willfully by an animated thing. What sort of animated things? Are you tasting the sexy jelly?
No, I did this, and so I got jelly on my hands. Or on my face.
Well, now Chris's jelly is all over your face, Sarah. Yes! Yes!
I saw where that sentence was going as it started it. I had to prepare.
Yeah, I couldn't stop it.
Did you see it coming, Sarah? Was that the...
I saw it coming, and now it's all over my face.
Just watch your hair. Apparently that's a pain in the ass to get out.
I'd say close your eyes, but you have the aviator, so you're okay.
What in all of Dinosaur Land could possibly have removed the explosive and hopefully not jellyish powering device, gadget, device?
The device, gadget, device?
Don't blame me. The aliens invented the damn thing.
This is true.
One of my tentacles will pick up a napkin nearby, and it will kind of like just start wiping the glasses off.
I don't know, but it doesn't matter because I'm just gonna go grab the one from the other actor and bring it over.
Good idea. So this is going to require you leaving the presence of the alien that secretes a very sexy jelly. No matter. They're dangerous things to do. Randy! Ginger leaves the ship and begins to walk towards the other ship, your ship. What do you do?
So when I finish punching the jelly with the arms of the alien, in tandem...
Can I see this, how this would look? I need this to be pantomimed. I need to see the pantomiming of Zangmak punching a jelly using Chris's arms.
I know, he's punching the jelly, and I'm punching the jelly at the same time, assuming that that's...
It's double jelly punching.
Yeah, exactly.
Tandem jelly punching.
It's like two arms, one jelly.
It's double punching. It's DP.
Yeah, DP.
Yes, exactly. Exactly.
Excellent.
Actually, I thought it was double fisting.
Zangmak, Kajer, as your GM, I demand that you engage in the mandatory activity of pantomiming DP live on stream.
I'm sorry, I can't.
That might break Twitch terms of service.
3, 2, 1, go!
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Now that's over with. The name's Randy. Pleasure to meet you. Did we just mate?
Do you have eggs?
Seeds. With little wriggly bits.
Are you a plant?
No. Although I can get very hot. Seeds.
Like bark?
Sure, like a stiff oak. That's a tree.
So you are a plant?
No. It's like the properties of the aforementioned penis stiffen when aroused. And when a mummy and a daddy like each other very much, they tend to...
Oh, no! I lost it when mummy loved daddy. I can't help it.
Yeah, I'm sorry. So, I'm gonna offer my hand and, like, to shake its hand. The name's Randy.
Facebook!
The tentacle wraps around your hand and,
What I?
Azorlon.
Fantastic. And I'm gonna walk to the medical bay.
All right. Zorlan, where are you going?
What happened? Like, how did I get here?
You woke up.
But where was I before this?
Oh, you were having a nice chat with Captain Darcy.
That's the last thing I remember.
Yes.
Where were we chatting?
On the bridge.
I'm going to be looking around then for Captain Darcy.
Well, as Ginger Wilde declared her action first, I shall resolve her first. So, the camera makes a whooshy noise, which sounds a lot like this. 3, 2, 1. Whoosh! And we view Ginger Wilde stomping across the grass. And as you approach your copy of the Raptor, intent on getting its device, and trying to wipe the jelly off your face.
It actually just seems to be spreading.
It's like glitter. It just, you can't get rid of it.
Does it in fact glitter?
Yes.
Okay.
No, but it sparkles in the sunlight.
Oh, wow.
Jellyfish with photosynthesis sexy jelly. I'm sorry, Zorlans. And the cat tail. I thought you were going to put it in your mouth. I was like, no. I was like, what?
I thought he was going to start stroking it personally.
As you march across the field, Ginger Wilde, you see something that might in fact be very, very dangerous. In your many space travels, in your many adventures with Captain Darcy, you have encountered before the cyber zombies. They're like zombies, but with cybernetic equipment. They are corpses animated by the most egregiously horrific technologies, developed in a time and space long, long away and far, far ago. And you see one shuffling about the Raptor, and it has in its hand 2 device gadget devices. Now, in all of your experiences with cyber zombies, you know 2 things to be true. 1, once they have infected a planet, purging them is almost entirely impossible. And 2, where there is 1, well, you've never been able to survive long enough to count high enough to see how many there actually are, but there are always many, many, many cyber zombies. They do not appear in singularities. They murder. They half consume the flesh of their victims, and then they install more cybernetic parts, which they manufacture from the natural minerals and resources of whatever planet they have infected. This is doubly concerning, you see, because this, you understand, is Earth, the birthplace of humanity itself. This is the past. If cyber zombies have found a way to the past of the Earth, the entirety of the human race could be unwritten before it is even evolved. What do you do?
You're muted. You unmute your microphone. He has 2 devices.
Yes. It would appear that he has stolen another one.
Damn it.
Where might he have found another Raptor? Oh.
There's 2. Now both missing devices.
Device, gadget, devices, yes. Yes.
Right.
Device, gadget, devices.
This seems dangerous. Do I see evidence of other zombies around?
You do not visibly see any evidence of there being more zombies, but you know
better than to think that you would ever encounter a lone cyber zombie.
Right. Do I know if they can, if they have a hive mind?
Yes.
Communicated that.
You do, and they do. Their king.
Then I'm gonna have to.
Their king was a unicorn.
That king was a unicorn. All right.
Was he fabulous?
The stories are true. Our cyber zombie's here. I'm gonna have to move quickly if I'm gonna get a device, gadget, device, device. I shoot the zombie in the face. From a safe distance-ish.
Roll me lasers! And no, there is no way you can feel how to shoot a laser better. It is literally rolling lasers. I will not accept any argument otherwise.
That's fine.
What about the force?
How many dice? I am prepared. I have
If I were to go into the kitchen right now, and grab a baking pan and fill it with all of the most delicious ingredients and bake you a giant pan of shut the fuck up. Would you eat it?
No.
Damn. What were you saying, Sarah?
I was saying I am prepared because I have myself a variable beam phase pistol, which is set to stun. I've fought these before, so I would know that they stun if they stun, right?
Yes, they stun.
Okay, great. Set to stun. I have the one-up on him because I don't believe he's seen me yet. How many dice do I roll?
You came prepared. You may roll 2d6.
Okay. I do not roll under my number.
It goes wrong. The GM says how things get worse somehow. So you reach into your vest because all dangerous space pilots dress exactly like Han Solo.
Exactly.
And you draw from your brown vest your phaser. Do line up the shot. And then you're going to take the attack! Oh shit. And the zombie turns. Achoo!
It's a very large phase pistol.
It's a very tiny.
I wonder where I was keeping that.
Is Ginger perhaps compensating?
No, Ginger is just very small. It makes the gun look way bigger.
Mm-hmm. Also, the gun's like closer, and she's a bit further away, so there's like the distance.
She's well shaved, Chris.
Thing. How about that? There.
You're not getting me.
You're using the correct angle. It seems thicker. It's not cold outside right now.
And it's roleplay. Use your fucking imagination, you asshole.
Imagine.
I appear to be allergic to the jelly.
Oh God. That is amazing, actually.
You're welcome.
You sneeze. The zombie turns. Achoo! And it looks at you, and you look at it. And it looks at you, and you look at it. And I forgot what you were doing. Oh, you're trying to shoot it. And you're staring and going, oh shit, I've lost my element of surprise. What do I do? And the zombie screams, ah! And then you shoot. And you'll shoot off the zombie's head.
Does it stun?
It does. But its screams have brought upon you the wrath of an entire cyber zombie horde! Kajer! Zangmak! You have been recruited to roleplay zombie horde with me! 3, 2, 1! The dancing one! The most dangerous one! It's upon you! This has to go terribly wrong for him. We have all these zombies. It would be a shame if she wasn't bitten and infected. Can you show me what that looks like? Because she has happy. 3, 2, 1, infect!
Nom 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 nom.
Oh God! Oh, get up!
I think I just ate my own jelly.
Now. Going back?
No.
Leaving our heroine in a perilous position, we swap cameras again. Whoosh in 3, 2, 1. Whoosh. The camera falls upon Zangmak playing Randy Spacebuck. And Randy Spacebuck, you are investigating the medical bay. What conversation are you having with yourself as you investigate?
So that was different. Yeah, but it was kind of interesting. I'm a fan of the pounding, as long as it's sexual pounding, of course. Yeah. What are we doing here? I don't know, but it seems like we should go to the sciency doctor area, because that's what we do. Except be sexy. And we've already done that, so let's do the other thing. No, let's not do the other. Let's go back and be... No. Onwards. I'm controlling the body. You do whatever it is you do as a second head. And I'll worry about the sneezing afterwards.
We have a stowaway who's also allergic to sex jelly.
Two. One. And has you round the corner into the medical bay. You see, startlingly, Captain Darcy himself in the medical pod. Just as he was on your copy of the Raptor. That's not possible. I mean, the odds of two different ships of the exact same make and model crashing in nearly the same place through quantum tunnels, that you can quantify, you can understand, but you know for certain that if there was only one thing that could ever be said about Captain Darcy, it's that he is truly, existentially one of a kind. And it is at that point, as you are realizing with dawning horror, that you may have found something that you don't understand. Your thought process is interrupted by and then get off me, coming from the other ship. It would appear that Ginger Wilde, the dangerous pilot, has finally bitten off more than she can shoot.
No, I believe that they bit off more than she could shoot.
What do you do?
And exactly what I need to do with the double Darcy problem, but I have an issue that demands my attention. Sir, stay frosty, Darcy. I'll be back. We will be back.
And I'm going to head out to the other ship.
As you run across the field, or do you strut at a very high velocity?
Randy Spacebuck does not rush. He gets there exactly when he's supposed to be there, so he will strut, but he's got, like, the Bee Gees music going on in his head, even though there's, like, pew-pew. It's like,
you can tell by the way I use my walk.
Right. So, we're going to have 10 solid seconds of Kajer eating Sarah while Zangmak saunters along struttily and slowly. Ready? 3, 2, 1, go!
10.
Nom, 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 nom. Nom, 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 nom,
nom, nom, nom, nom, nom,
one.
Nom, 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 nom.
It looks like you could use a hand or two heads.
Nom.
Oh, so close. You're not making me laugh that easy, Chris. You're going to have to try it. Although I must admit,
nom
was pretty good. That was pretty good. All right, so what do you do upon discovering the fact that your teammate has lost roughly 10 seconds of her body to 10 seconds worth of cyber zombies? Which are now curiously staring at you, somewhat distracted.
Are any of them hot?
I don't know, Chris. You're playing the zombie. Is it a sexy cyber zombie? I'll tell you what. We will judge the cyber zombie's sexiness by how seductively you can nom. 3, 2, 1.
I got nothing on this one.
I can
make that work. Hello.
And Crystal's is the point.
That just caught me completely off guard. I was just like, what? Where am I now?
All right. Did somebody ask what was going on?
Probably.
What is going on, anyways? What the hell are we doing right now?
I have just strutted my way over to a scene of cyber zombie-related carnage in which the dangerous pilot that is Ginger Wilde, that's the one with the glasses and the cane, which is actually... A super sweet space phone camera communicator scanner thing with universal translator, a variable beam phase pistol set to stun currently, which she's also allergic to literary sexual space jelly from Chris's character, which is on her face. I'm gonna take my super sweet space phone camera's communicator scanner thing with universal translator, variable beam phase pistol, which is set to science. And change it to hello.
All right. So how do you shoot the cyber zombie who is staring at you confused? How does it look when you shoot it with hello? I need you guys to play this out. Also, Chris, I need you to know what it's like to get shot with hello, because you're about to get shot with hello. Prepare yourself. Zangmak, describe.
So I'll take my totally not sponsored by Apple.
What is hello?
It's hello. not just hello.
It's how you doing.
How you
doing. Okay. How you doing.
Right.
Only from a phaser.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like a directed pulse of hello. Concentrated in whichever region you seem fit.
Okay.
Cookie's had enough. She just jumped out. She's like, nope.
Okay, so
I'm just like, right, we need to set this to hello, zap!
Yum.
Hello.
No.
Nailed it! Oh!
He got you.
Oh, God!
At what point does it count for two?
Oh.
There is no counting for two.
It has to be a separate gag.
It
has to be a separate gag to trigger another laugh.
I've been doing this wrong.
You've been keeping it in?
All right.
If you're referring to jelly, no, get this shit off my face.
All right, so.
That's not a shit on your face. That's a different thing entirely.
As it turns out, Ginger Wild, the cyber zombies are distracted, possibly aroused. Randy Spacebuck has come to your rescue with his sexy science. What do you do?
Has the space zombie that I, or the cyber zombie, dropped the doohickey gadget doohickey device thing?
Device, gadget, device, device.
That's it. Device, gadget, device.
Mm-hmm. The device, gadget, device. DG, double D.
The DG, double D.
The damn good double D's. There you go, Chris. You will never get it wrong again. I gave you one of those fancy word things to remember. Bye.
What he's saying is
that would be a mnemonic device. They are most dangerous. Has he dropped them?
I need you to roll me lasers to see if you were able to track that specific zombie in the horde of zombies consuming your flesh.
Damn it.
Do you want me to roll to shoot as well? We're just going to narrate that it happened.
I think we're going to narrate that it happened because we already had Chris shot, and it would be a pity if you missed.
It would be.
I rolled a laser feelings.
You rolled a laser feeling?
I did.
Well, you may ask one of the questions below and re-roll.
What's the best way to blank? What's the best way to get out of this fucking situation of being numbed to the face by zombies?
All right.
And here's my re-roll. I roll up my number!
All right.
Wow. Twice as well.
That cyber zombie was right here, right?
Yes.
Imagine me. Yeah. Imagine I am the cyber zombie, okay?
Okay.
If I am the cyber zombie and in one hand I have a device, gadget, device, device, and in the other hand I have a device, gadget, device, device, and I have just been startled and stunned with a headshot, and my head is now exploded. And I still have these device, device things. The device, gadget, device, devices. Yes.
Perfect.
Then, you are being nom 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 nommed, and then Randy is like, pew, and the zombies are like, nom. And then you watch, as in that very moment, the zombie, the cyber zombie, is like,
All right. Device, gadget, device, 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 gadget, device, device, mine! And I'm going to turn and run back to the ship.
Did I get anybody?
Hear any of that.
Nope.
Nope.
I didn't get it.
The only way that's going to happen is if you go to do that and you trip over your
Yeah, I got to top myself.
Yeah, and yeah. That's probably the only way that's going to get me. Just saying, if you wanted to.
Ladies, take notes. Now you know how to get Zang.
Mm-hmm. Make a tit of yourself. Woof.
I thought it was tits and vagina.
Arousing.
Arousing.
You need a little shiny tooth thing with the ding.
All right, so it has run off. It is getting away, and you are running back onto the ship.
Wait, does it still have them, or did it drop them?
Oh, it didn't drop them at all. It still has them. It's running away towards these fancy-looking ruins that shouldn't be there at all. What is that?
I thought its head exploded.
Is that Aztec? Is that Egyptian? Is it Egyptian's tech? Is it Egyptian?
It's Egyptian.
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 Guys, Genetech. Genesis tech. Oh,
Chris
look,
is cheating.
Ruins,
and Chris is cheating. We've already.
No, she started drinking water, so I was like, wow, I am thirsty. I was going to say that they're astroglyphics.
You're not supposed to be drinking during Laugh Track.
I forgot about that.
Because we had people cheating by drinking instead of laughing.
No, we had one person cheating because fuck you, Will. That's why.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
Well, Will was drinking alcohol. And that makes him...
Will just took a shot.
Ironically, to laugh. Sober
that was,
as fuck.
So cheating.
Yes.
All right. No, believe us. We are all doing this sober, and none of us are ashamed. Well, I'm not. Sarah might be. I have no idea.
I'm not yet. Even with the
jelly. I spent
jelly.
A little bit
weird?
Of shame on the couch.
To be fair, you were groping your own ass.
Yeah, so there was a little bit of shame there.
Hey, I feel a little bit of shame every time I grope your ass as well.
There was some ass shaming. You were ass shamed? Yep. Ready? Okay.
Which Anyways, is way better than ass shaving.
The cyber zombies run out that way
me with puns.
Towards these fancy-looking ruins that shouldn't be there at all because you are on prehistoric Earth, and there are no people to build ruins in prehistoric Earth, but yet there they are.
Oh, look, ruins! They look dangerous! And I'm going to run after them.
Well, I can now answer your laser feelings question. The best way to get away from a horde of cyber zombies while they are distracted is to run.
Perfect.
Isn't it that nice how that worked out?
Ding! So, I almost got you. Almost. Mm-hmm. Almost.
Mm-hmm. That wasn't nearly as good as the time that you were yeah. screaming, ah, and then you coughed out and then just ended it all with sugar.
Mm-hmm.
Chris is remembering this and trying not to laugh. Is I was hoping, like, the recollecting jokes of days past in a casual conversation way would, like, he'd laugh just because, like, you laugh when that happens and you're like, ha 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 ha, yeah? But no.
I don't remember doing that.
Oh, I got it. Happened. I got a clip of it.
Was it yesterday?
No, it was during the stupid recap of Jelly Beans and the Man Who Doesn't Pee.
Oh! Sugar.
Alright, so, your pilot has run off. What is, okay, now we have to, no, we gotta whoosh over to the alien, because Chris has been playing a cyber zombie this whole time, instead of playing his character.
Mm-hmm.
Ready, 3, 2, 1, and the camera says, whoosh.
Whoosh.
All right, so, you were looking about your ship. What were you looking for again?
Captain Darcy.
You were looking for Captain Darcy. Captain Darcy, on the bridge. Darcy. Darcy. Show me yourself looking for Captain Darcy.
Hello? Hello?
What?
No, I'm good.
I almost got them both.
I'm good.
For all your blooping, you do not find Captain Darcy anywhere you expected until you finally check the medical bay. And there is Captain Darcy lying, damaged, wounded, bleeding, kept alive only by the life support of the medical pod. And he lies there, strapped. What are you doing?
You said he's still bleeding?
Yes.
I'm gonna glue the wound shut.
With what?
Glue.
The fuck is wrong with you?
He's got super advanced medicinal super glue, okay? He specified this at the start. He said, he's a doctor, and he's got duct tape and super glue, and that's all I need, because if stuff doesn't work... You just need to use more of the same things until it does fix itself.
That, and I don't understand human anatomy, so I'm just winging it.
Which is probably the result of you not understanding human. We don't have wings. That's not a. It's not a thing we have.
Well, I'm.
I know it looks like wings when I do this.
No, it doesn't. You just look like you're having a stroke.
Ow! I just kicked something.
Can I do that?
Zang Mac is trying so hard.
That shit gets me so bad. Like, there's times where you just sort of go, ha ha! Ah! And you like fucking punch around. Like,
punch this thing yeah. over here, or the time I knocked my webcam off when I was flailing, or the number of times I've like slapped my microphone. It's amazing anything in this
world. I slap my microphone amazing. Every night.
Mm-hmm. Anyways. So, glue. This is definitely going to be a. You're just kind of like intuiting your way around the body, right? Because you don't know it, you're winging it by your own declaration. That sounds like a feelings roll to me.
Yep.
That's what you get for almost nailing me with bloop and glue. Bloop and glue, a new show brought to you by Kajer.
So, how many dice am I rolling?
One.
I am prepared.
Oh, you, no, this is within your specialty, you are a doctor. Two dice. Well, that's
well, I have to have passed.
Okay, Pluto Fairy. The fuck?
Just getting all my bases covered.
Well, how does this go right in the slightest?
You barely manage it. The GM inflicts a complication, harm, or cost.
Okay.
That's the official wording.
You... Oh, hold on.
You close the wound, but the life support pod immediately begins to scream that glue is poisonous to human blood. What do you do?
I suck the glue off.
You're not getting away without playing that one out on camera.
Wow.
Three.
I'm so surprised.
Dude. Two. One. If I don't get a gif of that in the next 5 seconds, just that, just Chris just giving head to something off camera, that has to be gift. I need a 10-hour loop of just that. That's going to be my going live gif for every campaign Chris ever plays in. Watch Chris suck at role-playing!
I regret nothing.
Really? Watch him suck at roleplay? Nope. Happening.
Come on, Zang, you know.
Nope, I'm keeping it straight, okay?
Keeping it straight.
Oh yeah.
Yep. No. Never again, Grant. Never again. Never forget.
That's what I had said about the fleshy cave. Never again.
Alright, so roll me. Lasers, no feelings. Roll me more feelings, because you're still winging it. I'm sorry, I need you to roll me feelings.
But don't I also succeed because I got both above and below?
You barely managed.
You barely managed to close the wounds and the complication of poison.
Then I succeed again.
What?
One success. Yep.
But then the complication. There's a complication.
A harm or a cost.
As it turns out, glue is also poisonous to you. You are now drunk.
Wow. There's
your complication and your arm, alright? I expect you to do alien weirdness while drunk.
Should I actually get drunk?
No.
Okay. There's something about you not trusting me drunk on stream. I don't know why.
Nobody should trust you drunk anywhere. You're you.
This is true.
Alright, so...
Right, so I've been sniffing glue.
Literally.
Yeah. Well, no, I was literally sucking glue. Hold on. Does that make my jelly extra sticky?
Too much air.
Does that make my jelly extra sticky?
You're going to have to find out.
Okay.
Wow.
So what do you do now? You've stabilized Captain Darcy. Oh, it is about this time that you hear a sneeze and then some screaming and then some strangely aroused zombie groaning. Coming from outside.
Do I recognize that as zombie groaning?
Roll me lasers. Have you encountered the cosmic threat of zombie zybers?
I assume this is not within my expertise.
Zombie zybers? If you fail.
Laser feelings.
Laser feelings.
Ask a question from the chart and then reroll.
In this context, where the fucking. Where is my chart?
What are they really feeling? Who's behind this? How could I get them to blank? What should I be on the lookout for? What's the best way to blank? What's really going on here?
I'm going to go with what's really going on here for 500.
Not only are cyber zombies within your realm of expertise, you and Captain Darcy are on a very important mission from the future. Flashes of memory seem to slam into your head. Can you show me what that looks like? Ready? 3, 2, 1. Memory!
Woo!
Memory!
Woo! Woo!
Memory!
Had to prolonged blink there to not look at the face that he was pulling.
But you have failed me, Chris. I need you to have memories slamming into your head while drunk. We're gonna do that again. 3, 2, 1.
Hold on, I need to actually brace my headphones this time because I nearly cracked them on the fucking.
3, 2, 1. Drunk memory, drunk memory, drunk memory, drunk memory, drunk memory, drunk memory. And as they...
Blue.
I'm like a sea of calm right now.
That was really close, Sarah. That was so close.
That was so close.
So you remember vaguely, as you were talking to Captain Darcy was like, you, the alien whose name the GM never remembers, and you were like, what's the GM? And he was like, just shut up, because everybody's drunk when you're drunk in your memories, right? And so, remember is him talking to you about like how the cyber zombies have discovered a quantum tunnel in space, and they have fired themselves into the heart of human history. They want to make all the zombies. They want everybody. And you're like, what's a human? And he's like, I am a human. And he's like, you were like, you're going to be a zombie? And he was like, yes, we need to go stop it. And you were like, how? And he's like, we need to go to the past and stop the cyber zombies. They are building a factory, a building that makes zombies. And you were like, oh, that sounds really terrifying. And he was like, I know. And then you were like, I should go right now. And he was like, no, we shouldn't. You were like, but you're going to be a zombie. I love you, Captain Darcy. And he was like, no, we have to wait for the crew. And then you were like, pushing the buttons. And then the ship was like, and then it crashed, boom. And then you woke up, and there was somebody feeling your ass.
He's a human. Wait. Zombies.
Factory.
Zombie factory. He's a human. I will jelly my way outside.
How does that look?
Much like floating in space.
Which is?
Well, it's more like... Something more like that.
So, something along the lines of like...
That's a... The level of failure that we have just reached.
I know, it's brilliant. Nope, can't hear a thing. I'm going to message him on Discord because.
Yeah. Oh, it's so not good, too.
Oh.
There we go.
Yes. This is the last time I space jelly anywhere. Holy shit.
What did you just jelly?
What did you kick?
Do you see this? I was like, blorpy, 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 and then my knee was like, fuck you! And it yanked the cable out of my microphone.
Oh.
That's brilliant.
Blorpy, blorpy, blorpy.
Don't jinx it.
But it was cute.
Alright, so there you are, like, doing your whole blorpy thing across the camera, right?
That's not a blorpy, that's a
And as you were doing this... You see a lone pilot, a very dangerous pilot, running off into the distance after a zombie that is like, hey, as it's like running away with the two things that you recognize as device gadget device devices, which happen to be the very source of energy upon which the zombie cyber zombie plague of the correct words of the right order subsists and powers itself, running towards the factory.
I'll get you, my pretty!
I... think she's allergic to my jelly.
You're going to need to put your microphone into your mouth again. Something about throwing your headset across the room by accident just ruined the sound volume.
Mm-hmm. What can I say? Baseball's not a real sport. Can you actually hear me now?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I was just saying that I believe she's allergic to my jelly. That can't be good, actually. Darcy is a human. I will follow the pilot.
All right. So, Randy. You have a horrific realization. You shoot that cyber zombie with a pulse of hello.
Hello.
And that cyber zombie immediately stands up straight, tilts her head, and says, "Gnome." And then you notice your space pilot companion, the one you haven't managed to seduce yet, is running off into the distance towards some sort of cyber zombie looking ruin. And then your new alien doctor, with whom you don't know if you have made it or not, which is a very strange circumstance to find yourself in, but one you find yourself in often strangely. Yep. Now you have a decision to make with your two heads. Do you chase the one that you have yet to conquer, or do you chase the one that you need to verify the conquering of?
This is so stealing it, but two heads as one are going to turn to look at the cyber zombie. Hold that thought. Smoke me a kipper. I'll be back for breakfast. And I'm going to go after the pilot.
All right. And as we bring a close to the second hour of Laugh Track Lasers and Feelings, all three of our heroes are running, sneezing, and blorping their strutting way towards strutting, sneezing, and blorping, which I'm going to need some acting here. All right. So, Kajer, I need you to start blorpy, blorpy, blorpying, and Zangmak, I'm going to need you to do me your struts, and Sarah, I need you to travel solely by sneezing in 3, 2, 1, go. And ooh, as our heroes travel towards the most dangerous factory ever to have been built in any of the histories of mankind. A cyber zombie birthplace, a hive of death and cybery.
Lore?
To find out what happens next, you'll have to touch that dial. Don't touch that dial. We'll be right back in 3 to 5 minutes. Don't touch the dial. Laugh Track begins now. Welcome back to twitch.tv/evilsqueegee and or youtube.com/evilsqueegeerar. If you have stuck around on YouTube this long, I appreciate you. I do. You make me feel good inside. When we last left our heroes.
No, I make him feel good inside.
You do not make me feel good on any side, let alone inside.
I make you feel good. You do not.
No,
all of them.
You didn't even make me feel good on the inside when you sprayed up Zangmak.
Listen, I will jelly all over your face, gluey or not.
When we last left our heroes, Ginger Wilde, the dangerous pilot, was running dangerously towards a cyber zombie factory circa early dinosaur AD. And we had Randy, who was strutting frantically, though not too rushed because that would be uncool and unsexy.
Exactly.
And we had the alien whose name the GM will never remember, blorping and jellying his way across the prehistoric plains, all in pursuit of a cyber zombie who was running toward the cyber zombie factory, and it had recently been revealed in the drunken memories that may or may not be a drug trip from glue, that cyber zombies have reached the past. Which it just so happens that one of our ships has crash-landed in by accident, and another one of our ships has crash-landed in on purpose. The cyber zombies have come here to infect the Earth before humanity has the chance to evolve, for humanity is truly the greatest enemy of the cyber zombie plague throughout all the galaxy. And thus, the adventure continues as soon as we blow up strut, and run once more because I never really get tired of doing this. 3, 2, 1! And as you arrive at the gates of Cyber Zombie Factoryopolis, the gates creak and groan as they open inward with cyber zombies operating cranks. Despite being cyber zombies with lots of technological devices, they are still using a crank chain gate because they find it more dramatic. However, hot on the tail of the zombie with the two device gadget device devices, which will supply the zombies with power they need to manufacture a plague that will consume all of the earth. It is inevitable that you three will also slip in before the gates are closed. And the gates close behind you. The ground rumbles, and you seem to have all caught up, apparently sneeze running and jellying and strutting are all at various points in their journey of the correct total amount of speed traveled that if you all left the same place at different times would arrive at the same place at the same
time. If one train is blorping, and it blorps the station at 2 p.m.
Yes.
That's just right fucking now, okay?
You all arrive simultaneously, looking at one another. And the zombies, which will... and they go about their zombie business. And Chris almost laughs. For those of you who are just tuning in, the current score, I believe, is Sarah 4, Chris 7?
6.
I think it's
Chris
6.
Chris 6. I think I'm down to 7.
Mm-hmm.
And Zangmak is rocking a solid, straight, erect 10.
Mmm! Woof!
10 out of 10.
Almost Why does he talk about erections he and you who, talk about barking?
He who laughs. Like,
what is,
it's a character.
It's a character. Some weird British thing.
He who laughs loses a point, and he with the most points, or she, although, let's get real, Sarah's not winning this one, at the end of the show,
but Zangmak is.
Will get a very special treat for their next game.
Could it be a doggy treat based on Zangmak's last fucking joke?
Yes.
Okay. It's not a joke, it's a characterization. I'll show you afterwards, it's fine, don't worry about it.
Right!
The zombies are shuffling about their business, almost completely ignorant to your presence, as if they're in the middle of Cyber Zombie Factoryopolis. What could ever possibly be going on right here that they would have to pay attention to? So they're just like,
beep. So all this discussion about humanity, it occurs to me that beep. Humanity and blue whales are very similar.
Beep. Why?
Because it's a humanity and it's a blue whale. Break the words down, they're very similar. You don't see the correlation?
No! But you know what? I do see a correlation too. Cyber zombies doing this and the Jackson 5.
Well, yes. They are the thriller zombies.
Mm-hmm.
Did you just put that together?
No.
Okay.
But it seemed relevant to bring it up now.
Is it relevant?
Relevant.
But is it relevant?
Relevant.
Is it relevant?
No!
Okay, good. I'm glad we covered that.
Good.
How's that sneeze taste? Goopy?
Like jelly. Sparkly jelly.
What does sparkles taste like? There is only one fucking correct answer here, and if you get it wrong...
Skittles!
That is not the correct answer, but I will accept
it's
it as a close
answer.
Second. Yeah. The what correct answer say? Is sparkles taste like fabulous! That's the only correct answer to that.
Yes!
Fabulous!
I don't know what the hell just went on between you two, but it was not sexy and we don't like that.
What?
Exactly.
You're right, it wasn't sexy. It was dangerous!
I believe
also, I have a rash.
Pierced the fourth wall.
It was dangerous. Also, I have a rash.
Definitely wasn't me. Ask it.
You have...
I think your jelly gave me a rash.
You have...
Oh, God.
That's irrational! I start rubbing my jelly on the rash.
Wait, stop. Is this the same jelly? Or is it a different jelly?
No, it's stickier now.
Is it gonna... Are you gonna make this worse?
I don't know.
Science man! Is it going to make it worse?
Do I look like a doctor? It'll be fine. See, that's the... You're a doctor.
You're a doctor?
I'm a doctor.
God damn, I see why the ship's gone to shit.
Yeah, did you kill everyone with rashes on your ship?
If so, that's...
There's only three kinds of rashes in the universe that prove fatal, and none of them come from my species.
Fatal to who? You or others?
I was going
to
say, has it been tested on my species?
What species were you again?
Fuck this shit! I need to find something to pilot, and or something dangerous, and or fire. You said fire.
Roll me, take care of this. Feelings to seek out the closest possible danger.
How many dice shall I roll?
Two.
I'm an expert. Okay. I get laser feelings.
Twice.
You may ask two questions.
What do I need to do to fix everything? And where the fuck did that zombie go with the device, gadget, device?
To fix everything, you must explode all of the cyber zombies, but it's not enough to shoot them. Then that gives them the time to repair. The words for the GM to use are, that would give them the time to repair.
That's a good thing that there's something alive in this temple that will explode them all at the same time.
Yes, you just watched a cyber zombie run inside with two device, gadget, devices, which, if clanked together three times and sworn at profusely, would explode.
I must stop the clanking. Dangerously.
As for your next question, where did that cyber zombie go? It runs deeper into the fortress, with its two fuel sources, and it runs directly between the giant, dangerous legs of a massive, hulking, cyber zombie T-Rex.
That's awesome. It might be my last act as well, because if I recall, I've been infected by these cyber zombies. And unless the doctor can save me, I too must be exploded.
I will suck the zombie out of you. It worked for the glue.
Can you show me what that looks like?
Yes, I can. Hold on.
Three.
No. Hold on. I've got a better answer.
There goes the town!
Yes, I can. Hold on.
It's the GIF, isn't it?
That's who's gonna go get the link.
The gif of Kajer sucking anything out of anything. I gotta make that bot command so it shows up on the screen.
Suck it.
I actually can't because I need somebody to permit me.
Do you have the two X's still?
Yes.
Alright.
There you go.
So,
that's what it looks like to suck the zombie out of somebody.
All right, so, Sarah, I need you to show me what it is like to have the zombie sucked out of you. Three!
Well,
two,
okay.
One! He's sucking harder. He's sucking so hard, it's lifting you up off the ground. He's dropping you. Oh, wait, no, he missed a spot.
Stop it! I'd rather be a zombie!
Bravo, Chris. That was clean. That was precise. You were like, I studied this bitch for three rounds. Assassinate!
That was beautiful.
That was on point, dude. That was amazing. Oh, that would bring Sarah down to two?
Yep.
I think so.
We have half an hour to run Sarah out of two more points, Chris. Can you do it? Can it be done? Ladies and gentlemen, laugh track just got real. Now, you were about to run towards the T-Rex, but then the doctor tried to suck the zombie out of you, and then you decided you'd rather keep the zombie. So as you are running, you can slowly feel the necropolitis.
Wait, no, that was a hyperbolic statement.
Well, he stopped.
No, he didn't. He went in again.
He did. He did do it again.
I forcefully sucked it out of her.
Oh, did
yeah.
You? Damn it, yep. I wanted to see Sarah.
Out of character, I wish to be clean.
out of character, if you wish to be clean, then I recommend you never go anywhere near any of these people ever again. Anywhere near this stream, because if there is anything we are, I assure you it is unfucking clean.
I will
out
say...
Out of character? Fair enough.
I suck the zombie out of you, but I gooed all over you in the process, so...
Oh, gosh, so now I'm just gonna... It's gonna
so
be
now every time she takes nonsense. A step, like, the goo on her feet is gonna be...
Well, not just that, but it's also... It's got glue in it, so she's a little bit, like... Robot-ish.
Like...
Yeah. Too bad I've never played anything like that before.
Why, thank you. My sound effects are fantastic. I know. Where were we? Oh, yes. We were... ...ing towards the T-Rex.
I gotta say, I'm impressed with your use of that in a sentence.
Right? Mm-hmm.
That was good.
Anything was a good is a word if you try hard enough.
Anything is, in fact,
I'm pretty sure I think I
just heard
something else, but
I think I just heard Jen, like, twitch in rage in the other room. Alright. Giant robot T-Rex, cyber zombie, pilot gooily running towards it, no longer zombified.
Gooily.
Gooily.
It's awesome.
Anything's a word if you try hard enough. What are you doing, Randy? And Randy...
It's not a sex Rex.
It's not a sex Rex, no. I'm going to change the setting from hello on my super sweet space phone camera communicators kind of thing with universal translator and a variable beam phase pistol, which is currently not set to stun, which it usually would be. It's currently set to hello. It is going to be set to... Fuck. EMP.
Do you want to EMP the cyber zombie T-Rex?
I do want to EMP the cyber zombie T-Rex.
Why don't you roll me lasers?
Oh, this is gonna
be
fun.
You are prepared, so you can take two dice.
Fantastic. Roll those ones. Nope, I fail.
Something goes wrong.
Goes wrong. Yeah.
I'm consulting with somebody who knows exactly how to make the T-Rex go horribly wrong. One moment.
I wonder what in the hell you were doing.
I mean...
Alright. So. You line up your shot. Which of your two heads gets to be the one to aim? You're muted.
Wouldn't...
Muted.
Both of them. That's both. Probably
what goes That's wrong. What I was going to say. Like... Wouldn't it be like the right eye of one? No, like they're putting their heads together.
Yep.
And lining up the shot between the two eyes. Like, how do you not know that?
All right. God, what noise does an EMP phaser make when you pull the trigger, Zymac? You have made the T-Rex sneeze. Do you know what T-Rexes do not like under any circumstances? Sneezing. Do you know why?
Is it because their arms are too small to wipe
their
nose?
They cannot wipe their nose! God damn it. God damn it. You beat me to my own damn joke.
Was that a laugh?
That was...
It was a proclamation of victory.
The audience needs to decide if that was a laugh. Those are the rules.
I would not vote that as a laugh. But... I look at the T-Rex and I say, I feel you, bro.
Now, fully enraged that you have made it sneeze, for it will have to forever live with the discomfort of cyber zombie snot running down its cyber zombie nose, you have angered the T-Rex. I need
looks
you to
like...
Me... Go ahead.
I said, it looks like I have its attention. Perhaps you should go do something dangerous whilst I stand here occupying its time with my... Damn sheer sexiness. I agree. We should do that. Go. Forth.
I'm on
dangerous.
It. I'm on it.
Alright, so I need a roll from Randy. It's going to be a lasers roll.
Goddamn.
This is not inside your expertise, nor were you prepared to have to dodge giant T-Rexes. So as the T-Rex comes down with a... to try and eat you for making it sneeze, I need you to roll me lasers. In addition, I need to know what it is that our dangerous little pilot is doing.
Oh.
Did you just botch?
Yep.
Well, yeah. No dice succeed, which is always a botch.
I'm going to be climbing the T-Rex.
I'm going to be closing in on the zombie, trying to keep the clanking from happening.
All right. So, I need to know what it looks like when you climb a T-Rex's jelly. Because, yeah, 3, 2, 1. That's
pretty good.
That's pretty damn good. I gotta give it to you. That that evoked exactly what I am now picturing, this giant T-Rex with this like jellyfish being like an old video game, like the arcing. That was
pretty good.
That was really good.
That was very fluid.
I've done a very Nintendo.
I can almost hear like
the weirdest part is that I know some of these Nintendo songs.
Yep.
The weirdest part is that I know some of these songs and I don't even know some of the games that they come from. I know which one that one is.
Alright, so you go up the T-Rex. Meanwhile, you are going to make a mad dash to tackle that zombie. Roll me lasers!
I have to save Darcy.
How many dice? Two?
One! Two!
What?
Two. This is dangerous.
Yes! Nope.
Yep. We are the worst people.
We are the worst.
How do you
by the way, full on body slam. That was the plan.
All right. So, what do you plan doing when you're on top of the T-Rex?
All right. So, I have two arms and a handful of tentacles. Once I sit upon the T-Rex, I realize that I have the answer to save Darcy.
Okay.
Yes, because zombies are flammable. And so I will grab my tentacles in my hands and aim them like a fire hose with my multiple arms and my multiple tentacles. And I will begin spraying my goo all over every zombie nearby from atop my perch.
I can't believe there is actual precedent for this to cause fire. Because it was declared earlier. Was that a laugh? Was that a laugh from Chris?
Oh,
his whole body was chuckling.
No, that was just me moving with the gooing. Moving with the gooing.
What?
Gooming. Gooving. Goovy, baby. I don't know what he's doing.
I have no idea. I think he's trying to take a selfie with us. It's fine. Don't worry about it.
Surprise, fucking surprise! Chris has managed to solve the problem again by setting everything on fire. And once more, I can't just declare he's inserting it randomly because his alien jelly jizz was declared as flammable in the first hour of the game. An example of the exclusive content that you are missing by not following me on Instagram. So you are going to blorp jelly all over the T-Rex?
No, all over all of the zombies. I'm spraying it like a fire hose.
He's got a vantage point and he's just covering everything.
I'm shooting it from my tentacles. Out the end of my tentacles.
I'm uncertain if this breaks Twitch terms of service, but I'm going to run with it. All right. So, get it runny. Running with it.
It's not
Zang
very
just
runny.
Made the ew face, so I'll take that as a win right now.
It's not very gooey. It's not very runny. All
right.
It's
I need to know what this looks like and what this sounds like, Chris. All right. 3. There are 3 fingers here. 3, 2, 1. Go!
I'll save you, Darcy!
Yet another thing that will be taken out of context and just plastered everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Whew. All right, so atop the zombie, T-Rex, the cyber zombie T-Rex. Wow, this is like the most metal thing I've done since werewolves fighting sharks.
That was last week. That was literally last week.
There's the biplane golem as well. Okay, so so the jelly that you may or may not have mated with, Randy, is spraying his jelly love everywhere. All over the place. The entire zombie factory is just slurped upon by your current slash future slash potentially ex mate genderless friend, question mark.
Oh no, we met after the incident.
With benefits.
I like the way that Chris has somehow managed to literally bukkake everywhere. And everyone's just like, fine.
And now they both go.
No, I wasn't laughing.
You
I was
laughed. Just... You laughed just now.
No, I want that to go to the audience.
All right.
I want that one to go to the audience.
That one go to the audience. Don't go to the audience. I know Sarah's down to 1 point, though.
I'm trying to time it just right.
No, that was just me being happy that he nailed you with it.
And go.
Wait, go what? Oh, pole?
The pole.
Pole, yeah. Go!
There.
Pole, go! Did Kajir laugh?
Pyro, fuck off.
It looks like you're getting crushed
on. The audiences, yep. Sorry, man. Sorry.
Y'all can suck my bukkake.
All right, so
I can't. Gives me a rash.
The jelly alien bukkakes upon the cyber zombie army while riding atop a giant zombie robot T-Rex. Meanwhile, Randy critically botches his roll to escape being jumped upon by the dinosaur. And I have to ask, if the dinosaur is coming down like, and you're gonna be like caught in its mouth, right? I need to know, what does it look like to be jumped upon by a T-Rex, Zangmac? 3, 2, 1, T-Rex!
Oh, goddamn, I like being eaten, but not like this!
Not like this! Not like this!
I am gonna get you with that eventually.
One day. One day over the rainbow, when you sneeze, there will be someone laughing, but it will not be me.
Nice! That was
thank
good!
You. Thank you! Thank you!
Beautiful! Beautiful! Gorgeous!
I don't really know why it is that the T-Rex was played momentarily by the Gingerbread Man, but it felt right.
Right? All right, so I'm going to pretend I got that joke, and we're going to move onward, because right now I have to resolve you failing to tackle the cyber zombie. All right, so this is what I'm envisioning. Like, here's the zombie, right? And here is Ginger Wild, the dangerous pilot.
Dangerous.
Did you just hit your head on your desk?
No, I used my hands to make a sound as a Foley artist would. Did it work?
If it had have been your head, I think I would have lost my shit.
Yep, if you had actually hit your head, I was gonna die.
You just don't have the commitment to sell it!
Show her how it's done, Chris!
I actually can't write down stuff in front of me.
That's what I thought. And the cyber zombie turns around and sees you coming, and it holds the things aloft, and you're like, oh shit, I did not plan for this, and then boom, you hit the ground. The cyber zombie falls way back, nice try, falls way back and tosses the device, gadget, device, device, and the device, gadget, device, device, sailing through the air, tumbling.
Psht, I shoot them with my goo.
Alright, round 2 of the encounter with a cyber zombie T-Rex and the bukkake'd upon cyber zombie army begins now.
No, it's a gukkake now.
A gukkake.
Very good. Gukkake.
I like that. It. Yeah. It's got,
it's got style. It's got grace.
Yeah, it's got pizzazz. I like
it's it. It's got glitter.
It's got close. Almost tripped me up.
Right in the glitoris.
We have a dinosaur!
Get out.
Right there.
Get out.
Did you say dinosaur?
And Chris goes down!
No, but I wish I had now.
Wow.
I honestly wish I had cracked that joke. I should have.
All right,
I was already halfway there.
Chris, I don't mean to give you any pressure, but you have 15 minutes.
All I need is a match.
Or butt stuff.
Oh, no, we started with butt stuff, so we have to end with fire.
We did the pounding, yeah, we're good.
No, that's true.
We already pounded that shit.
All right, so we're going to go with everybody except for Jelly Bukake Man to start with. All right, so our camera's going to flash over to inside of the T-Rex's mouth. Ready? 3, 2,
goddamn.
1. Whoosh. There you are, in the T-Rex's mouth, all right? What do you do? Or you. Whichever wants to do something, I'm fine.
You know what? I am going to... I'm literally really quickly... I'm going to bat a fuck out of its tonsil so that it doesn't actually close its mouth.
Are you going to like... Are you going to try and like... All right.
So I'm like... And I'm just going to go... Bang!
All right,
So, yeah.
Like every other problem you have ever encountered in life, you find that battering somebody's tonsils might be the answer. I mean, generally, you're not using your fists to do this.
I mean, pounding one way or the other is just pounding.
All right, so I need you to roll me feelings, because for you, pounding is an innate, intuitive thing.
It is.
Admittedly, you've never pounded inside of a T-Rex's mouth before, but hey, who are you if not a man who likes to try new things?
I love new things. Especially battering in someone's tonsils. Two dice?
Two. Yes.
Two?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh my god, I succeed!
But something goes wrong?
No.
Oh, you succeed fully.
I fully succeed.
All right, well, I was going to have the T-Rex vomit.
I do it well. Good job.
Okay. So no vomit. Well, no, that just means you don't get vomited upon. So instead, right, there you are like, oh no, oh, you know what, pow, and you turn around and you just pop that motherfucker with your fists, right? And the T-Rex, from everybody else's perspective,
you right literally there, just hit him in the mouth with your fist.
Wow, that is an old school reference. All right, so like, there you are, like this, right, the T-Rex, and the T-Rex is like, brr, brr, brr. Right? But you are clever, having battered in quite a few tonsils in your day, if you know what I'm saying. Which I hope you do, because I've lost track at this point myself.
No, I'm good. Yeah, carry on.
All right.
Wow.
Yeah. I'm with it. It's
all right.
Good.
So there, the two, you know there is to be, right? And so you have already, you know those like action movies where like, the guards are patrolling around the hallway and you look this way and that, and you don't know where you're supposed to go, and then the camera flips to the guards coming around the corner, and the Piro is not there because they're like, this on the ceiling? You're doing this on the ceiling, on the roof of the T-Rex's mouth. And as the T-Rex is like, you will fall out of the T-Rex's mouth and land with a thud in front of the T-Rex on your back and scramble to your feet, and you will look up having defeated the most dangerous cyber zombie maw.
You need to work on your gag reflex.
I think that's the weirdest taunt I have ever had a player throw at a monster at my table, and that's saying something from I play with Chris.
I know, I know.
Alright, so, Ginger Wild, you have just had an unfortunate face-related collision incident with a cyber zombie. You face-planted, and the two clinky bombs are sailing through the air. Currently, they are now slippery with goo and gloopiness. What do you do?
I shoot one of them with my device, my laser, set to explosions.
All right.
Just one, mind you.
Roll me lasers with one bonus die.
I just want you to know.
Two dice.
Oh,
I just want you all to know that, like, I realized that I was in the middle of a gukake at the time, but I was basically imagining, like, I was going to be Spider-Man with those two devices, and I was trying to goo them into the wall.
That's not how jizz works, Chris.
It is when I have been sucking glue down.
Look, I realize that you're supposed to make it sweeter by eating pineapple, but eating glue does not make it stickier.
Maybe it does for a jellyfish.
Alien two-armed monster thing from another planet that may or may not be a doctor and doesn't know a thing about humans.
Are you seriously attempting to argue the physics of eating glue to make jizz sticky right now, Zangmac?
He's an alien! It makes scientific sense!
Alright, let's have this argument. What species of alien is he?
I actually did cite that earlier.
He did say something. I don't know. I can't remember.
Well, if you can't remember and you don't know, then how do you know that the kind of alien he is does that if you don't even know what kind of alien he is, Zangmac?
With counterpoint, how do you know that he can't?
My question is, how can I convince the zombies not to clank the things together?
I thought you were shooting them.
In case this doesn't work.
Easily, by not suggesting they do so. They're not planning to clank them together. They're planning to plug them into the machine to make infinite cyber zombies. Clanking them together might be the only way to stop them, because it would create an explosion large enough to well, especially now that they're all covered in, flammable jellyfish jizz. That's the face I made, too, when Chris said that. Don't worry.
I got another laser feeling.
It's jelly jizz.
What is your next question?
Is there a way to not die in this process?
Maybe it's a jizz fish.
Is there a way to not die?
Is there something that will shield me and my newfound compatriots and the one raptor we need to get away and one of the devices so that we can all leave in happiness and tranquility?
You would need...
a big red button. I think that would do the trick.
Did you say up Grant's butt?
A big red button?
Oh, okay. My brain heard the G of big and then red, and my brain was like, oh yeah, Grant. Yeah, that's what that was. And then I just didn't hear the on at the end of button. I was like, Grant's butt is going to save you from the explosion? What?
I was going to say a gubrella, personally. Or just a goo coat.
Also, I succeed in shooting one of the things.
Wow.
Damn.
Like, really well.
Mm-hmm. This is my second double botch. Double critical, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
This game.
What if we can just treat the gukake as, like, one of those water slides?
And then the next one. This is going to trigger a massive explosion. This is a power cell you have just shot with your phaser, set to dangerous, if I recall.
Set to explosions, in fact.
Okay, so Chris.
Yes?
You have just spent the past entire combat round hosing your flammable jelly all over everything in sight. And once again, Sarah has somehow managed to combine an explosion of some sorts with a highly flammable substance. Does that count as a laugh?
It's not usually...
Mine didn't, so I would suggest
it didn't last time I did that either. I have to confess, the last time we played Laugh Track, I did the Evil Witch laugh, it didn't count. Unless you're using it to cover up an actual laugh, then it counts. So, Chris, in your most terrifyingly triumphant of moments, right, the entirety of the zombie cyber threat is going to go up in a giant jelly-fueled explosion. And you are riding upon a T-Rex, and all that is visible is the jellyfish silhouette of the doctor riding upon this mighty beast, spewing everywhere. What do you do? Take it away in 3, 2, 1, action!
Did I just mate an entire species?
Did you just go limp at that thought? Is that what just happened? Was that like... I just sleep with... Oh...
Maybe. Maybe it was.
I'm not sure I should.
So in the middle of the drama, the explosions, the jelly splashes, the bits and pieces of zombies flying everywhere, you sit thoughtfully on top of the T-Rex's head, looking at your limp...
tentacle.
Tentahose.
Hosical?
Hosical. Hosicles.
I think it's hosicles.
That's just fun to say, hosicles, hosicles, hosicles.
My hosicles are still dripping, though.
My hosicles bring all the boys to the yard? No?
They burn all the boys in the yard, apparently, based on the zombie catastrophe.
True. Alright, so, explosion! And the sudden revelation that you may have just had sex with as many people as you will ever have sex with in the entirety of your life.
At once.
At the same time.
That is kind of how a gukkake goes down.
You, in the most appropriate choice of words I think I have ever found for any circumstance in my life, the strong emotion radiating from Randy in this moment is overwhelming. He is so jelly right now. Oh!
You almost got him.
Almost. I almost got you.
I have been thinking about that joke this entire session, but I couldn't find a way to deliver it that wasn't too forced.
All right, so, Randy, roll me to save the dangerous pilot's life. How are you going to do it? She is so close to the sailing explosion. You see this about to happen, and in that split moment, you decide to...
So... I'm going to be reaching out to get the canister with the goop, like, around it. At the same time, I'm reaching to grab her to, like, pull her out of the explosion. So I'm kind of like, you know, I'm trying to do, like, a twofer. Grab the canister, grab the girl. That's how I'm trying to do it. And I'm not trying to make, you know, there's no reason here. I'm here to perform science. I need that canister and impregnate the women. That's all feeling. That's how I'm doing. That's what I'm doing.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so in this moment, we're going to have an Alfred Hitchcock freeze, right, as the narrator stops and walks towards the audience, and he says, "All right, now, audience, you, the viewers, I need your assistance in thinking this through. There are only two roles I can ask for. One, he will almost assuredly pass. Two, he will almost assuredly fail. The question is, dear audience... do you understand what hangs in the balance? Because if he fails this role, we very well might lose Ginger. Ginger Wilde. Those sad, sad puppy eyes. By which I do not actually mean that she has the face of a dog. That's not what I was saying.
She can't be having puppy eyes. She's a human. I thought I covered this.
If I ask for a roll of lasers, it is very likely that she will die. If I ask for a roll of feelings, it is likely that she will live, and therefore I put her tiny, puny life in your very capable hands. Come on, chat, tell me what I should do here.
We've already got two votes to kill her.
I haven't voted yet.
No, I'm saying from chat.
The correct response to that was, okay, so we've got three votes to kill her. Come on, Chris, you've let me down.
No, I'm sorry, I'm limp.
Wow.
Wow, guys! You know what? No more sexy aviators for you guys! It's done. It's done. Oh, thanks, Hero!
Oh, Pyromancy buys a botch to Zang. Zang Mac. Because I actually like Sarah. I like Sarah a lot. She is a friend of mine. I appreciate Sarah's company.
Only one
so despite the fact that chat has asked me to call for a lasers roll, which will almost assuredly kill her, I'm going to ask you to give me a roll that has a very high chance to succeed. I'm going to ask you to roll me feelings to save Sarah's character. All right?
Okay. Three dice?
Yes, three. I want the maximum chance for her to live.
Okay. And, so I need to roll. Oh, I botched, thanks to pyromancy.
Oh, no!
I don't know if you could have got the headphones to slip down intentionally.
There's no way you could have forced the headphones off of your ears, but that had the best dramatic, like,
was that, did that
pizzazz?
I gotta go back and watch that later to find out if I got the pizzazz right. I'm sorry, Sarah. I gave it my best shot. I did everything I could.
You did everything you could.
I am totally on your side.
Yet again, in the hands of pyromancy, one of my characters meets
their
demise.
I have a suggestion. Yes, so I'll run forward for this because I'm not quite near them. But I'll run forward. I don't know if you heard, but I'm here to perform science and impregnate. And as I reach out to grab Ginger, I actually push her instead of grabbing her into the explosion. So I'm here to impregnate. Oh shit! Well, fuck.
Ladies and gentlemen, and in this moment, the cyber zombie plague was cured in a giant explosion brought upon by none other than that alien whose name I cannot remember, Zuba, and his slutty, slutty cyber zombie loving ways. Many heroes died this day. All of them were Sarah. Mostly because pyromancy. Tune in tomorrow at 10 a.m. EST.
Can we have a quick count on the
watch,
laugh track?
To watch to 10 a.m.? 10 a.m. It's Saturday.
I kept the last laugh, by the way. The last laugh is mine.
Did I say you could stop dancing? No, I didn't. That's right. Yeah, keep it up. All right, 10 a.m. EST, be there. Zymac is the winner with a full score of 10. I don't think he laughed even once. Does he even have a soul? What is wrong with you? Are you a robot? Bye-bye! Follow me on Snapchat!